at these elections, Uhuru Kenyatta. He strongly denies the charges and has called for a delay in the start of the trial. Now, the ICC chief prosecutor, Fatou Bensouda, has told the BBC she is concerned about the protection of witnesses ahead of the trial. The BBC's Karen Allen has this special report.
It's the final lap on the campaign trail before Kenya goes to the polls. But the long shadow of the past still haunts people here. Clashes after the last elections brought Kenya to the brink of civil war. Tribe became a language of hate. Attacks and counter-attacks lasted for weeks, triggered by a dispute over who had won the presidential race. Now, away from the campaign trail, the silent evidence of the past is fighting to be heard. Extraordinary claims still to be tested in court. The plans to unleash violence were hatched at the office of the president, State House, using a criminal gang called the Mungiki. 5 years ago, we gathered evidence and reported on those secret meetings. Now, many of those foot soldiers who it's claimed were hired by the government to do its dirty work have simply disappeared.
Definitely there is an attempt to interfere with the witnesses. I have to admit, it's quite a challenge.
Has it been more of a challenge in Kenya than anywhere else?
It has been quite a challenge in Kenya. We know that there are elements who are actively working to find out who our witnesses are. I think this is very irresponsible, because I believe that those who tell us their stories deserve to be protected.
I've come to a safe house to meet the widow of one man accused of being involved in those murderous attacks.
When they came, I saw him washing guns, and I was not used to see those things in my house. I used to ask him, you know, what is going on? He asked me to just shut up.
Jane's husband, Minor Diambo, then vanished, presumed dead.
Vanished.
Important lead, seemingly silenced. Back on the campaign trail, a sensitive time. Uhuru Kenyatta is hoping to be the next president, but he and his running mate are among those facing trial. Charged with crimes against humanity at the International Criminal Court, charges they vehemently deny.
Is it in the best interest of Kenya to continue fighting for the presidency?
What is in the best interest of Kenya? That's what democracy is all about. Allowing the will of the people to rule.
Wouldn't it be better to clear your name first?
The process is going on. The pool are not interlinked in any way whatsoever.
Meanwhile, Raila Odinga, his main rival in the presidential race, is a man who felt robbed of the job last time around. His supporters staged violent protests on the streets, claiming the vote had been rigged.
Decorative event, decorative sculpture, Bouvet, station of bus. Walkers. Mr. Walkers. One meter 78. Parkings, auditorium, and towers.
Tap into the latest stories, share the ones that matter to you, and see how local events impact the world at large.
We are going to cut the local events. Is the touch mute? Silence. So, Mr. Walker. Mr. Walker and his church of cloud. Mr. Walker and his church of noise in Viña del Mar. Level Street. We have a parasite noise outside the windows. It's a fool that only work con clavitos. There is no clue here. You can see there is no hay clavitos. Esta gente representada por tornillos o algún lápiz o alguna escultura de tornillo o alguna escultura rosada o alguna escultura de candado o alguna escultura de cuchillo cortado. Se termina el cuchillo, se termina el martillo en esta proposición urbanística. El silencio se oye en la calle, porque además los buses aquí solamente pueden parar acá, no pueden parar aquí. Entonces ahí está el lápiz esperando el bus. Y acá no puede parar. Eso se puede realizar con un semáforo aquí y un semáforo acá. O sea, nunca hay automóviles que se paran frente a la explanada. Entonces los clavitos, los claxonitos, bye bye. Y entonces el auditorium, con las horas de varios lugares, horas, un mural global, un auditorium y horas de ciudades extranjeras, Le Cap, África, Ottawa, Canadá, Chicago, Estados Unidos, San Francisco. Eso por la primera fase. Después, Nueva York, Caracas, Lima, Tokio, Sydney, Santiago. Luego arriba los instrumentos de meteorología. Para medir el nivel del ruido urbano y multar al clavador, claxonador y psicópatas del ruido urbano. Luego otras ciudades, otros relojes, Montevideo, Barcelona, París, Londres, Roma, Jerusalén, y allá, por el fondo que hay, New Delhi, Pekín, New Delhi, Jerusalén, Pekín, New Delhi, Jerusalén, Roma, Londres, París, Barcelona, Montevideo, Chile, Hour, Sydney, Tokio, Lima, Caracas, Nueva York y San Francisco, Chicago, Ottawa, Le Cap. Cap. link up. Es una idea de... Jorge Efraín Bravo Salgado. Firmada, idea firmada. Idea firmada, Bravo Salgado, Jorge Efraín. Bravo Salgado, Jorge Efraín. Todo lo que hay que hacer para firmar algo aquí en este país. De la copia y el clavito. Firmada la torre también. Firmada Jorge Efraín Bravo. A donde Madame y Monsieur Bravo Ramos, Avenida Marina 154, departamento 72, Viña del Mar, Chile. Séptimo piso, distrito 14. Y ruiditos de clavo en calle Nieto. Y ruiditos de claxon en Von Schroeder. Que lo llaman el concertito de la Marina. Sobre cuatro ruedas de cobardía. Está allá afuera. El concertito de la Marina de cuatro ruedas de cobardía. Suena con clavito y con claxon en Von Schroeder con Nieto. Ah, y ahí se callan, no dicen nada, ¿viste? Cuando se les firman. Tienen su garaje, antiguo garaje Arteaga, que se cambió por Rara, Ara, Ara, Automotriz. Y cuando se les firman, se callan. Bueno, y aquí al interior la maqueta firmada. Firmada, firmada. Ah, y de nuevo el clavito computante, social computante del exterior. Valle interno, plaza, valle interno. Entre el auditorium y su estación de meteorología. Y la torre para el Instituto Geográfico Militar e Instituto Nacional de Estadística. Un piso por región. Idea Jorge Efraín Bravo Salgado. 10.024.665-1. 100 metros y unos cuantos pisos, un piso por región. O sea, ningún auto, no puede subir ningún auto. Y los teléfonos portables, el portillón se los exige con la tarjeta de identidad. Y se los devuelve cuando sale, cuando salen del edificio. Tienen que dejar su tarjeta de identidad y su teléfono a la entrada. A unos guardias de seguridad y firmar su papelito para estar seguro de recuperarlo después a la salida. Y nadita de rotaciones de identidad. Que es el gran deporte de este país de Chile. Allá afuera, ¿ves? Torres de rotación de identidad. Pajaritos de rotación de identidad, autos de rotación de identidad. Y protestando con claxon, como androides.
Well, certainly we expect to have a very, very significant amount of snowfall within the state throughout, particularly along the coastal region and back up in towards our foothills. So that's one piece that we're looking at. We're also looking at some very, very high winds, gusts upwards of 60 plus miles per hour, which can cause us additional problems. And then we're also looking at the very real possibility of some significant coastal erosion. So we're looking at about three different challenges at this point.
Well, so how are you preparing for all this?
Well, what we do is our power companies obviously are well aware of the situation. They understand where we're likely to get the worst pieces of this weather. They bring down extra crews from Canada come down to assist us so that they're in the standby mode. Right now, we haven't had any significant reports of outages, but they're ready to roll if we have them. Our Department of Transportation, of course, we're far north in the country, so we are used to moving a lot of snow. So right now, they're able to keep up with it in pretty good shape.
Go ahead. I was going to say, Maine, you're used to snow a little bit more than other parts of the country, perhaps. But what advice would you give to people who are there, residents, people who are in Maine visiting?
Well, what we always tell people is try to be ready to take care of yourselves for the first 72 hours after an event like this. So hopefully they were all aware of it. They've got their food stocks in. They've got their medicines. All those kinds of necessities are taken care of. And they're prepared to just basically hunker down and wait this one out. Obviously, the less they can get out on the roads, the better it is, not only for themselves, but also our snow clearing crews.
Right, because we've been hearing from forecasters this could be the worst in decades. Do you have any specific concerns?
At this point, I think coastal erosion is my biggest concern. That's where we could lose some property, and that would be more serious, perhaps, than 2 feet of snow. Yeah, it sounds like a lot of snow, but it's a light, dry snow, so it's fairly easy to move, and the plow folks are used to dealing with that.
All right, Robert McAleer, best of luck to you and your crew, the director of the Emergency Management Agency in the U.S. state of Maine, joining us there on the line live. And by the way, if you were wondering, that was the Sunday River Snow Resort, just to give you a sense a little bit of a ski resort, I should say. You can see the ski lift there to give you a little bit of a sense of how much it's snowing, but people are out and about. It is a ski resort. You do want snow there, so it really has to get extremely bad for people not to choose to go out on this day. All right, we'll have a lot more on this storm as New York prepares for it as well a little bit later. Now back to the Arab Spring, the revolution. Some have developed better than others, and there is certainly a crisis in Tunisia right now. It wasn't quiet or even somber at the funeral for that slain Tunisian opposition leader Shoukry Belaid. Clashes broke out between protesters and police outside the cemetery in Tunis, where thousands had gathered for the procession. The murder of Belaid on Wednesday has truly thrown the country into turmoil. Here's Dan Rivers.
They came by the tens of thousands, noisy, angry, and determined to show Shokri Belaid didn't die in vain. This felt more like a political rally than a funeral.